Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 4.3, Problem 4. This is Section 4.3, Problem number 4. It says, compute the values of the correlation coefficient r and the coefficient of determination r squared for the data shown in the table below. So to compute these values, that's the big formula with the r. First thing we have to do is fill out a table, and the values from the table will help us fill in the formula for r. So our table will have a column for x, a column for y, a column for x times y, a column for x squared, and a column for y squared. So, the x column fills in very easily. Just copy the values of x, 3, 7, 8, 14. 3, 7, 8, 14. The column for y fills in just as easily. Just copy the y values that are given, 0, 2, 4, 10. Now, the rest will involve some computation. So, for every row, do x times y. In the top row, x times y is 3 times 0, which is 0. In the second row, x times y is 7 times 2, which is 14. And the next row, x times y is 8 times 4, which is 32. And finally, in the bottom row, x times y is 10 times 14, which is 140. Next, do x second power. Now, make sure you're taking the values of x, not the column right next to you. X. So in the top row, x is 3. So x squared, 3 squared is 3 times 3, which is 9. The next value of x is 7. So x squared becomes 7 squared, 7 times 7, which is 49. The next value of x is 8. So x squared is now 8 squared, 8 times 8 is 64. And finally, the last value of x is 14. So x squared will be 14 squared, or 14 times 14, which is 196. And finally, one last column to go, y squared. And again, make sure it's y that you're doing the second power. So these values for y. So top row, y is 0. So y squared becomes 0 squared. 0 times 0 is 0. Next value of y is 2. So y squared becomes 2 squared. 2 times 2 is 4. The next value of y is 4. So y squared is now 4 squared. 4 times 4 is 16. And finally, the last value of y is 10. So y squared is now 10 squared, 10 times 10, which is 100. Now, the chart is completely filled out. And what we have to do now, before we start filling in the formula for r, is get a total of every column. So for the values of x, 3 plus 7 is 10, 10 and 8 is 18, 18 and 14 is 32. The values of y, get a total. 0 plus 2 is 2, 2 and 4 is 6, 6 and 10 is 16. Next, x times y, 0 and 14 is 14, 14 and 32 would be 46, 46 and 140 would be 186. X squared, get a total of the x squared column, 9 and 49 is 58, 58 and 64 would be 122, and 122 and 196 would be 318. And finally, y squared, get a total, 0 and 4 is 4, 4 and 16 is 20, 20 plus 100 is 120. So now that we have the totals, now we can write out the formula for r. The formula for r will have places to put in these totals that we found, and then we'll do the computation and get r. So the formula for r is the total of x times y minus the total of x times the total of y over n, and then in the denominator there's that big, big square root. And in the square root there's going to be two sets of parentheses. The first one, total of the x squares with the second power inside the parentheses, total of outside the parentheses, minus total of the x's squared, total of symbol now is inside the parentheses, squared is outside, over n. Then there's another set of parentheses. And it's the same values that we did for x, except we do them for y. So we start with total of the y squares, where the second power is inside the parentheses, the total of is outside, minus total of the y values squared, total of symbol inside the parentheses, squared outside, over n. And close the parentheses. That's a big formula. So start filling it in. Fill it in carefully. If you fill in correctly, you'll probably get the right answer. If you make a mistake, this is usually where it happens. Most people fill in the chart with no problem. They get their totals with no problem. If you have a calculator, you can do this math, usually with no problem. This is where people make the mistake. When they're putting the totals into the formula, they get kind of the parts mixed up. A lot of them look really similar. There's where you really want to take your time. Don't do any plug-in and computation simultaneously. You'll get most of it right, but you really need to get all of it right. So waste the extra 20 or so seconds that it would take to fill it in with no computation, then do the computation. Just fill it in. Don't be in too much of a hurry. So first thing to fill in, total of x times y. I have an x times y column. The total is 186. Then I have minus. And I set up a fraction. Top of the fraction, total of x. So the total of x. I have an x column. The total is 32. The total of x is 32. Times total of y. I have a y column. The total of that y column is 16. And n is how many data points are given. Now in this, it's an unrealistically small number of data points. There's only four. Like if I drew the scatter diagram for the original problem, there'd be four dots on it. So n is four. The number of data points is four. Now I go down into the denominator. Big square root. Two sets of parentheses. In the first one, total of my x is squared. The second power is inside the parentheses, so that's done first. You do your work in parentheses first. Then the total of is outside. So after we've done the second powers, then we get the total after. That would be the column labeled x squared. We've done our second powers first. Then we get the total. It would be 318. Minus. Total of the x is squared. Again, it looks like the same thing all over again, but notice the parentheses are different. The total of symbol now is inside the parentheses. So we do the total first of the x's, which is the 32. Once we have the total, then we will raise it to the second power. So I'm going to have to do 32 times 32 on the next step. That'll be a big number. In the denominator, again, n, which is still four, number of data points. Close that first set of parentheses. Open up the next set. Do the same thing for the y values now. So I have total of the y values squared. Second power is in the parentheses. Do your second powers first. Total of is outside the parentheses. So you do the total after. That would be the very far right column on our chart. I've done the second powers first. Then I do the total. That comes out to 120. Minus total of the y squared. Again, total of symbol is inside the parentheses. We make the total first. That would be the total of the y column, 16. And then I'm going to raise that 16 to the second power, which I'll do on the next step. Underneath that, I have an n, number of data points, 4. So now the formula is filled in. If you can get it this far correctly, the rest is a matter of computation. Tedious, yes, but not necessarily complicated. Take your time. Let's do out my multiplications first and consider that one entire step. So, on the top of the R formula, this 186 will stay 186 for another step at least, minus, Now, I have 32 times 16. 32 times 16 is 512. Underneath we have a 4. I'll divide that out on the next step. In the denominator, 318 minus 32 second power over 4. So 32 second power is 32 times 32. That's 1024. And you still have a 4 in the denominator. I'll take care of that in the next step. And I have another set of parentheses next to that. 120 minus 16 second power. And I have a 4 underneath. 16 second power is 16 times 16 is 256. And I have a 4 under it. So, numbers got kind of big. Next step, I'm going to divide out the 4s where I have them. So, in the numerator, I still have the 186 for one more step. Minus 512 divided by 4 is 128. And now, I have my square root. I have one set of parentheses, starts with a 318. Minus 1024 divided by 4 would be 256. And there's another set of parentheses next to that, so that's with 120. Minus 256 divided by 4 would be 64. So, looks a little better now. I'll continue on. What's going to happen in the next step is I have 3 subtractions that can occur. So 186 minus 128 would be 58. Now remember, don't let the square root go away. You have to work all the computation under the square root down to one number, then do the square root, then it's gone. A very common mistake, people write the square root for the first several steps and just let it disappear on their own before they've done a square root. Don't let that happen either. So the first set of parentheses, 318 minus 256 would be 62. And the second set of parentheses, 120 minus 64 would be 56. So now it's looking a little bit better. R equals, I have a 58 in the numerator, and then there's a square root underneath. 62 times 56. I've kind of reached the limit of what I can do without a calculator at this point. I could do that without a calculator if I had to, but since I remembered to bring one, I'm going to go 62 times 56 equals 3472. Now I have one value under the square root, so now I can actually do that square root. The square root of 3,472, that I also cannot do without a calculator, is 58.92367945. So, the last thing we have to do is do that division. So, again, you definitely want a calculator. You're going to enter the top, 58, divide by the denominator. 58.92367945. You don't really need that many decimals, but the right way to do this is keep all the decimals until the very end and don't round it until the end. So let me do that division on my calculator. And when I divide 58 divided by 58.92367945, the answer I get for R, 0.984324138. That's R, the correlation coefficient. The question also asks for the coefficient of determination, which is R raised to the second power. So for R raised to the second power, I'm going to do that number, 0.984324138, and multiply it times itself, times 984324138. The calculator will do that for me. So that gives me R squared, or the coefficient of determination, is equal to 0.968894009. Now, at this point, if you're doing a problem and it said round it to two places or three places after the decimal, now is when you round it really for the best accuracy. So that's the final answer. R is approximately 0.98 with some round off. And R squared is about 0.97 with some round off, which is super high accuracy.